Has got the final lap. Zach Millett crosses the start finish line, takes the white flag, final time around for the 315. It's that S4 guy off of turn number two, down the back straight away for the final time. Into turn number three, clean and green, no pressure in the back. Zach Millett from three and four, off of turn number four, looking for a checkered flag. Zach Millett sees it, checkered flag for Zach.
It's gonna be intriguing. Can Blaze fend off Millett through all this? It's gonna be tough on the back straightaway, but if you can keep him at bay, at least through here, you have a chance. Well,
nine requires so much tire. Here we go, down to the inside. Blaze is blocking. Big blocks there from Drew Blaze. Millett sends it up the inside. He's gonna go way deep and exit though, but he hangs on. Wow.
Turns three and four. Car's not running. Wiggles off four a bit, crosses the start finish line, and he brings it home. Saves enough fuel, he's going to win.
Absolutely dominating fashion, start to finish. No contesting, no issues whatsoever. Perfectly clean car. Zach Millett's going to be your winner here at Lime Rock.
Zach Millett, your final two turns here at Watkins Glen International. Dominating fashion, leading nearly every single lap. Zach Millett wins at Watkins Glen. First win of the year for that number 350.
Through turns 19, down the short jaunt into turn 20. Final turn for Zach Millett this afternoon from Circuit of the Americas. Millett off turn 20, almost loses the truck. It doesn't matter. He's going to take the checkered flag.
Final corner here. Yep, we are coming to the checkers. The white flag never triggered on our system, but the checkered flag did. Millett's going to go back to back, and he's going to be the last to first and win here at the Iowa Road Course.
27 laps to go, coming to 26 laps to go.
This is going to be a crucial spot right here. What happens?
Shoot. Oh, Lordy. Oh, Millett loose.
Oh, nice grab right there. Oh, my gosh. That was close.
Zach off of turn number two into the backstretch for the final time. He drops it down low. Nobody close enough to really even challenge the 315 at this point. It's a 6.5 second advantage back to second place Steve Requino. Zach Millett through turn number four gets into the dogleg, sees the checkered flag. It is waving. Zach Millett is going to win the My Cricket Makes Truck Series race here at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Zach Millett is going to win the My Cricket Makes Truck Series championship.
What's up, guys? We got a little LSR action, LSR Truck Series. We're at Sonoma. 58 laps. This should be fun. So we haven't made a lap in practice yet. But we've got a bunch of laps in. We've got a lot of laps just for fun here. Almost looks like my spec map's a little messed up. Wow, qualifying's 15 minutes. What do we got? We've got 18 trucks, looks like. 20? 20 trucks. Not bad. We have to start last, unfortunately, so... Hey, what's up, man?
What's going on? Debacle? Yep. Debauchery? I don't know. Whichever.
It'll be a show of some sort.
A show of
gonna,
shit.
Milt's going to throw down a two-second faster lap than everybody. Either that or he's not going to qualify. Not going to show his hand.
That was kind of the practice technique. Yeah, it doesn't take long, does it? It's a shit show, man. It's awesome.
And then it doesn't help when I got, you know, Drew Blaze rear-ending me while I'm on the line to push the truck around.
Bill Mofield races in Crocs. That's your fun fact for the night. And man, that's awesome. Can't imagine. Turn this down a little bit.
Yeah. All right, let's see what we got. Takes longer to get around.
It says my mic's connected. Yeah, cool. Bill, I like to race in Walmart shopping bags.
Yeah. You didn't come across.
Yeah, I did.
I'll be right back.
I heard it.
You want to be pretty careful on the opening lap here. Whew. I don't want to kill your tires. Doesn't take much to get your back tires too hot, and then there's no grip for the lap that matters. kind of poofed this lap already. Well, I hope that's enough. We're a second and a half to the good so far. Yes, sir. Just a cheater, apparently.
Matt Minnick, admittedly not a road racer. He did point that out. He says,
all one of zeros are all down to me. I'll all of them cross it.
I think you'll be okay.
A little human. My message, you're just a little human.
A little human.
Bill, it did complete his second lap. Was not faster than 1861.
I'll meet you on the drag strip. You and I will just race there. You know, I was going to say that a little bit.
We're looking good so far.
You know what? We're just getting into the drag strip. We might be able to handle
it. Awesome cameras.
Very difficult to put the power down without losing the rear end.
I'm telling you, I can run tour mods for years and I'll shoot around.
Ah, Kevin, we were talking about the off track. I saw you had the first issue going up the hill. Did you catch the second one?
And I'm like, I'm just going to go hit that bank.
119.98 for Matt Sisler. It's going to put him fourth quick for now. Jesus, that's going to wrap it up. It's a 10-minute session. We've got 2.5 minutes remaining, so we're going to step aside here and break out of the way.
Who do we got? Who we got?
I would definitely recommend the Garza Law.
Fits the G. What's up, man? Thanks for the follow.
I've been playing basketball ever since I can remember. I just finished my 6-year career playing for the University of Tennessee. I feel like we're both starting.
I'm trying to make the screen look just about right. Yeah, there we go.
And has always come through with it.
One way to find out.
I can do donuts in the pit lane. And if they say anything, I'll be like, I'm just doing what Drew Blaze does. Minnick. Minnick. Was it Minnick?
There. Minnick. Ball fan engage. Right. We're good to go now. So if we get this pull, filming, bud. Filming. What, you need a hug?
Why was he doing it like?
Yeah, hell,
because
come on then.
They specifically said park him for the driver's meeting. Oh.
What's up, dude?
Did you know bats are really good?
Bats are really good?
Yeah.
Bats are really good.
Yeah, but they eat mosquitoes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, bats are good. All right, bud, we're going to start the race. Wish me luck, okay?
Just go
ahead. Yeah, bring it in.
So,
love you.
Love you.
Ugh. We should have done this race in the 86. Then I would have stood a chance.
Oh, man, that would be insane.
Have you driven it?
Yeah, it's not bad. It's weird how you get back to the gas and it wants to do a wheelie, though.
Yeah, the front is really stiff on it. Like, even, like, if you're turning hard under braking, like, the front kind of bobbles. It doesn't matter now.
All right, fellas. Get ready for a great race.
Super amounts of fun, and then we took it to and it was even more fun. Wait, Kevin, Blue didn't qualify either, huh?
What?
Sorry about that.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the virtual Sonoma Raceway, LSR Racing Truck Series Road Race 149. Your starting grid on the pole position, a lap time of 1 minute 18.049 seconds. This is 315.
Beautiful. Volume's all crazy here. If I can hear you guys. So we got the poll here, but let's get this stuff ready first before we start talking. There we go. So even though we technically got the poll, we have to start last due to wind penalties. So coming from the rear is going to be something else from this track. It's going to be insane. Here's the part that hurts. Okay, there's the last one right there. Come on, Bill. Copy that. I know, I feel like I'm going to get a black for that. I think I'm going to have to let you back by, Billy, because I've got the EOL. It'll give me a black flag if I go by you. My man. I hope they get an answer here quick, though. They better actually hurry to do it, or else I gotta let them by. It already gave me a black flag. I haven't even crossed the line yet, but it's a good start, boys. We're good, Billy. Little scrape, no biggie. Rough start. Thank you. One by one. So we don't want to kill our tires coming up through the field either. Cody, what's up, buddy? Boy, I miss you, seeing you out here, man. Appreciate the sub, too, man. Wish you were out here with us. Doing a little by little here. It's this one thing. It's really hard to look at that damn thing without trying to die. Oh, bluegrass trucks. No shit. I'm gonna have to look into that. I've heard about them. You should get the new SCAR too, Cody. It's called the No Bull Series. It's gonna be a lot of fun. And easy to the gas. It's so hard to not light these freaking tires up. Nice and easy. Keep it right in third there and be very ginger with it. Thanks, man. get loose already. Nice. That's cool. It's hard to find him now, man. So hard to find a passing spot. Gonna have to move him here pretty shortly. Man, Brian, you disappeared for a solid 4 seconds there. That was scary as hell. Yeah, it looked it, didn't it? That was the worst place to lose him, too. That was scary as hell. Gay? I've had worse, yeah. Matt's good shit. Matt's fast too, he's right on my ass. This is the hard part though, you know, this is where I think guys like, you know, I know Drew and Matt Sisler definitely saving tires, you know, these guys are going to come up through while everybody else burn their shit up.
Thank you.
It's loose right there. Wish I saw more of that. I quit. I quit. Ginger. Got her, boys.
Welcome back. It might be in trouble in the hairpin. Just as he cut away, now I got to find him. Here we go. Back away. Ryan Rose looks to be involved in that one as well. Yeah, we saw Ryan slipping through tires a lot. Most of these corner exits just keep them hot. And unfortunately, that problem just gets worse. Very hard to keep that truck straight out. Really loses the turn one.
Brian Rick, damn it. Game of survival, man, that's for sure. We're not even really far into the run yet either. Sorry about not responding much, guys. I suck at reading that and trying not to die.
Looks like
Oh, hi. I'm like the worst at trying to read that thing right now at this track. If I glance away, I die. Oh man, that was scary. Thank God for triple screens, man. I knew I had a little damage from getting around Martin at the start, but I don't feel it at least. Yeah, I was fully puckered. I've got it up on the top screen. Think of the viewers. I'd probably take some rear brake out of this thing pretty quick. They're fun as hell to race, man. I love those things. Traffic, I don't like it. Gingerly, gingerly. Could have cut the track or something, yeah. That's a good point, Steve. On the straightaways, it's hell to look up. It's a real life problem, man. Life of a race car driver. Yeah, you should be bulletproof by now. Hell yeah. Oh, JJ left already. Shit. It sounds stupid, but leave it in third for every corner except for the last one. Yeah. Right. A little bit in the first of the run, you're going to feel slow as shit, but it really saves it. Yeah, he is.
Boy,
gotta back that one up even farther. Fuel, anyway. Yeah, it gets predictable, doesn't it? I mean, if you just know it's going to try to kill you every turn, you just know what to expect. Oh, he backed out, did he? No shit. That's what I want to do in that corner right there. Keep the momentum up. See you, man. Big shout out to Steve Singer for doing the broadcast tonight, too. Just got COVID, sticking it through. Brett. Whack-a-tuck. Another 15 laps or so. Getting a little sporty now. Right about now, pretty happy that I saved my stuff. Thank you, sir. What's that? Yeah, I hate that damn corner. Sounds good, Goose. Thank you, sir. Oh shit, you're upside down. Impossible. Second gear is just about useless now. Thanks, Bill. It's flying by again. Whoa. got another 7 laps. Skip Harbor Racing School. So we're good to pit really whenever now. Basically when it really sucks, I think we're probably a lap or two out. She's sketchy. Look at the tire grip difference coming out of last year. I think we're going to pit this lap. I think I'm going to end up pitting this lap. There we go. We're halfway, might as well. Yeah, that's weird, isn't it? I'm gonna drift that fucker. I think. So we do have that damage, but I am not gonna fast repair that, just in case we get into an issue, maybe a lap truck or something. Speed. That would not be smart. Yeah, it's a terrible spot. Sounds pretty intentional.
Top of the hill.
think we're still in the lead. I think Sean Pitt with us here. Pick that one up. Cranked all the way up for tonight. Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah, that track's insane. Dude, rally cross cars, they're insane. Oh yeah. Ten out of ten, highly recommend. Yeah, it's fun because I like how you have to set up the passes, you know? Sometimes it's a whole lap to do it.
Drives, driving line 100%. Trying to get this for turned off.
Somebody in the chat said I use a driving line. Thank you, stream. It could be. No. Yeah, fuck that thing. PJ's in the pits. Just hang out by the exit and wait for him. That'd be epic. He didn't reply though, did he? Sorry, buddy. Slid a little too far. Oops. Sorry, Kevin. Slid a little too far there. Nah, I just kind of painted him up a little bit. Pops, what's up, dude? And Britt just popped in the chat. Britt says, no admins, no rules.
Huh. Oh man.
Send it. I missed that one by about a mile. Definitely save that replay. That truck. I totally followed that truck. Shit. Thank you, sir. Currently running in the fifth position, that battle between himself and Mike Fahey. got it. Something significant happened, but I can't look up.
Whoa.
Big Blue, thanks, buddy. Appreciate it. This is by far the hardest damn race to try to keep track of that shit. I suck at this multitasking stuff. You distracting son of a bitch, you. I gotta come up with something. I don't know if I gotta move that screen down or something, but looking straight up, trying not to die, that's freaking, that's something. Packs yet.
Bobby can't let the crew so much shit in bluegrass. Just from LSR League.
Ouch. Little secret to grip pack. You can achieve level 3 grip pack, and all you gotta do is just squeeze the wheel a lot harder. I feel like I'm about to rip this freaking thing off the hub. Our stint here. We're on 13 laps. We got over 20 laps good to the fuel. We're just going to stay out. Frigate.
Whoa.
Big push. Yeah, I think Steve's pretty bored too. I mean, he's not feeling too well too, so that doesn't help either. Looks like we're all on the same pit schedule. That's nice that there's no cautions. We don't have to worry about really any strategy. Just kind of send it to the end, and don't die. Pretty much the same laps as second and third, so I don't think I'll be catching them.
Yeah.
Ooh, there's a little screen flicker. We got a pretty good snowstorm outside, so that would be pretty shitty if something happened. Guess worst comes to worst, at least we'll get most laps led. Come on, old girl. We could come down and get a set of tires, but we could actually, I think we'd stay in the lead. I don't see the reason to, though. It's not dreadfully bad. We actually got Matt right there in front of us. We're not going to push the envelope. There's no reason to lap anybody. That, you know, we're not going to, like, push to do it. Loop it or something. Oh, you can feel the scoliosis setting in. The other two guys just for decoration.
So Feeney maintains the sixth position. First truck on two laps down. Really doesn't have anything to gain going forward. Once he gets in the other position, the car is good. And the chair a little bit behind him. Six laps down.
Demarius Maxwell. I had to redeem myself for hitting the turn to all last race.
Fifty-two. if Matt's right there at the finish, I'm going to pull over and let him back by for the lap. Shit, well, Matt's pitting, so. Yeah, we got plenty of gas, we're good. Oh, man, my neck is absolutely killing me. Yes, sir. to ask something or not. Gonna take the white here in a second, Billy. Well, this is what we needed to do for the points. This is a good night. Good stuff. Get up here and get out of the way. Thanks, man. Or maybe I just paid more. Thanks, man. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. This track is crazy fun. Thanks, man. Thanks, Pops. Appreciate it, man.
Zach Millett, victorious. We're going to step aside here and get one more break out of the way. We'll be back, hopefully, with our top three finishers after this.
I will definitely recommend the guys of all arms to all my family.
All right. Get our Discord up here. I think everybody's off track. Oh, Sean's coming. That was fun, man. I love this freaking track. Demanding as hell. Good run, guys. Set some slow motion goodness here. Oh, here, let's get our results up. Actually, here we go. All right. I'll be back, guys. John, what's up, man? Good run. Dude, me too. My hands are absolutely killing me. My back is absolutely killing me. It wasn't even a long race, but it felt like 3 freaking hours.
Yeah. I think some of it is like all the, just the, how bumpy and...
Uh-oh.
You know, you're constantly moving around, constantly trying to keep the car going in the right direction while trying to manage the tires.
Yep.
Yeah. Ryan kind of got me. Like,
yeah, my spec map's messed up on here, but I think Steve had it right at least. Weird how it's white on that. Got the wrong one in my file, I think. Minimize this because we're going to be brought in here. Can you hear me now, Pops? That's the best part about this track, man. You have to plan your passes so much.
Yeah. I was just getting by PJ early on, and then he finally made a mistake. I was able to get around him. But also, it's only my left hand that's killing me because I'm also racking an H pattern doing this thing.
Oh, you're the man. I should have. I pussied out with it, man. I'm not going to lie. I did try it.
In the draft, feature winner, Zach Millett and Steve, the HBR-TV booth. You got us?
Hey, Steve. How's it going, man?
Going well, sir. It was a tough one to call from up here in the booth, not because of the race itself, but for obvious reasons. But tell us about your race. You put the truck on the pole position. Got that thing done with a blistering lap. I think it was a second and a half faster than anybody else out there. But you had to drop to the tail, wind penalties being what they were.
Mm-hmm.
You had to start from the rear, and within a lap or two, you were mid-pack. Walk us through what it took to get through all of those trucks so quickly and then get out front and keep it there for the balance of the race.
You know, we wanted to come in and basically maximize our points night. We were coming in second in the points, and being the last road course race of the season, it's really my best chance to, maximize it and do the best we can. I know Drew was really strong in the last two races, so I had to get what we had to get tonight. Qualifying went pretty well. We had to get the pole, get the points for that. Did pretty close to our fastest lap. The race was kind of perfect for us. You know, I didn't want to, like, rush up through there, make a mistake, get into somebody. Everybody in this league always races so clean, so I mean, as long as you can hold your line and make good choices, you're going to do okay. So I'm glad it worked out.
Well, again, it was impressive to watch you put on a clinic out here. I got to ask, I mean, what makes you so good on these road courses? You're fast just about everywhere we go, but on road courses, it's a completely different ball game. I can't keep up with you. I hate to say I'm pretty quick, too. They're certainly faster like yourself, but what's the secret?
I don't know. I think I just like the, like the stock cars around road courses. They're just kind of, I don't know, they're just right for me. I don't know. I just used to sliding them around all over the place because I know when I'm racing with you on road courses and other cars, like Radicals, you're usually smoking me. So it's fun to jump in these things because, I mean, they're so hard to get around these places. That's the fun of it, you know.
So you talk about sliding the truck around, and we did see a lot of that happening tonight. Not so much with you. But just as an example, we saw Brian Rose. He was unable to really keep the power down. He got the rear tires heated up early, and ultimately it bit him. We saw Mike Fahey run into that early on. We're getting the throttle down a little bit too soon on exit. You had mentioned it pre-race. You get too much heat in the tire too early, it's almost impossible to cool them down. How was the strategy on your end? Like, what do you do to not do that. I know the temptation to just hammer down and go mm-hmm. is always there, but you got to take care of the truck, and you did a good job of that tonight.
Yeah, it was funny when I was behind Brian. I really thought to mic up and tell him what I was doing to try to keep the truck underneath me, because it looked like he was drifting pretty good, and I realized that his mic wasn't working, which, you know, I knew all night, I just forgot. But, you know, I did a couple different stints in practice right before the race, and they're about 25 laps each or so. And the first stint, I just absolutely sent it. I went right down to first and second gear on every exit and just absolutely lit the tires up and tried to make pace. But I'd say about nine laps in, the rear tires were just done. And it affects everything. Your entry, your apex, your exit is just awful to drive. So the second stint, I stayed in third on most exits. If I had to go down to second, I was about half or maybe even a quarter throttle. It really made a difference. I could keep lap time for past 20 laps or so. And if I didn't do that practice, I would have been out there probably in the wall.
Well, either way, you didn't get it in the wall. There's a little bit of right side damage on that truck. Any idea what that had come from?
Yeah, it was just the start. Taking the EOL, and we're trying to decide if Billy Martin's going to get a EOL right before the start or not. So I kind of slowed down to a stop just to make sure that he went across the line before I did, just in case. And then when I went to go past him, it was kind of in the tough spot right past the line, and I barely just scuffed him. Luckily, it didn't bend anything. That would have made things very interesting.
Well, nonetheless, you still brought that truck home in that P1 position here to close it out. Another checkered flag for Zach.
Hey, Steve.
Man, congratulations.
Thanks, man.
We're going to let you get out of here. We're going to pull second and third place and see Sean Roberts and Matt Sisler up here. Before we do, though, who do you want to shout out to?
I'd like to thank you, Steve, and HBR TV for the broadcast, as always. LSR, it's always a great league to race in. A lot of great guys in this league. It's sad that the season's coming to an end already. Track Bar Media. And shoot me a follow on Twitch and YouTube at ThatS4Guy. Thanks, man.
The back end just started coming around on me.
There we go.
Went to the grass and
good stuff.
That was that. I finished in fifth place.
See, at least you managed to finish fifth, whereas I had to reset, and I ended up spinning again along with him because I was so pissed off. So I ended up, like, ninth when I should have been on the podium easy. It was you who, like, the opener at Daytona where you and I...
Oh, you and... I don't...
Where we caught that GT car coming to the end. Oh, wait, no, that's Zach.
Yep, I'm back.
I, man.
I think it was you and Sean, though, for the record. I remember watching it.
I'm pretty sure it was. And the great thing is, Steve got it right on the money when it, like, he caught us right as we went, right as I got to his inside when we caught the GT car. And we just around him, and we came... went around him, came back side by side to the fast lap. Like, oh no.
That's awesome.
I mean, yeah. Brian was... Man, I thought you were going to kill Brian at a certain point. Like...
Yeah, dude, I was right on him, and I couldn't mic up and talk to him, you know, because his mic has been frigged up all night. He was so stressed out about his microphone that he picked the Chevy instead of the Ford. That's why his paint scheme was all messed up.
Yeah,
Pops, it's my kind of my local nickname.
I mean, if I picked the wrong one, it would have been, you know, our team has a Ford and a Toyota, luckily, so if I had picked a Toyota, I would have been same thing, same pain.
Right.
It would have just been a Toyota, and therefore my Ford-loving, Toyota-hating teammate would have hated me for it.
Yep. Yeah.
And I had no idea where he was. I got on, and then he flashed back in front of me. I got on the brakes. I got into him. And then as I tried... tried to turn in to make sure I didn't, you know, run him over, I got on the power and
Yeah, but there's some scary moments in that race, man.
Well, Matt Daniels did not want to let me by.
Yeah.
He was lapped out.
Yeah, there was a lot of that.
There were some. I think there are some guys that don't know how to be passed.
Or if their relative is even on, you know.
Just ignorant of the truck behind you.
Yeah, when I caught Brian, it was scary. I was trying to stay off him, and he was just lighting his back tires up, and right when I got to him, I was making the move, and he disappeared, and I shot past him, or so I thought I did, and then all of a sudden he just like appears again right in front of me. Yeah, shooting through me. I was like, holy shit, that'll be fun to watch.
Yeah, I'm glad I didn't have to deal with him and all his issues. It looked like he dropped out after a while.
Yeah, he ended up hitting the wall. I think he just killed the tires and it was undrivable at that point.
Okay. Yeah, I was funny. I looked down and my spotter said 20 to go. I'm like, what? 20 to go? I thought this was race almost over.
Right. I know it. Did you just pit the one time for tires?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. Yep. I figured, hell, we could make it on gas, and we were kind of far enough away.
Yeah.
Worked out.
Yeah, I saw no reason. If there were cautions, if there was a late caution, I would probably might have tried to throw a set of tires on it.
Shit, we'd
but with no caution, it doesn't make sense.
Yeah, we'd be on lap, like, what do you think, lap 11 by now, if we had cautions on? I think we'd lap 11 or 12. It'd be a long-ass night.
Probably.
Man.
All right, man, I gotta take off. I know these guys are waiting for me over in the review.
Yeah, enjoy that. I'm sure there's lots to go over.
Yeah, well, I saw there's one, so we're gonna have to go over in a second here.
Oh, man. All right, man, good racing with you. We'll catch you next week.
All right, see you next week.
See you, buddy.
Yep.
Yo.
Yo.
I'm gonna end the stream real quick and be right back. Hold on. All right, guys, that was a good night for us. We did exactly what we wanted to do. We maximized our points, and so we got the pole, the most laps led, lap led, and the win. So should be a full pole. And another cool picture done by Justin Johnson over on LSR Gaming X. I think he was streaming tonight. I don't know how long he was in this thing for. I don't know if he crashed or what. I was trying to pay attention to it, but, dude, tonight it was hard as hell to keep track of the chat and, you know, the broadcast even. I mean, I could hear Steve, but anything beyond that, I was almost useless to looking at this top monitor. So sorry if I didn't reply very quickly. I was trying not to die. So, but yeah, great night for us. And the next scheduled race, even though I failed miserably at scheduling them on Twitch itself, but next Thursday, I think we're at Iowa, which I don't remember really anything about that track. It's one of those cookie cutter tracks. But, yeah, we'll see. We'll get some practice in, and, yeah, we'll see how it goes. We should have taken the points lead with this race, so that's pretty cool. We missed the first two or three races, so, I mean, it's kind of cool to even be, you know, running for it. But, enough of me rambling on. We'll catch you next Thursday, hopefully. So, thanks for watching. See you.